Hello guys and welcome back. So this is the second video on the tutorials. We're gonna do now the second tutorial together. Now, you see, I forgot to mention that in the last video that aside from the circuit diagram and the instruction, there is also the actual program that you need to run the tutorial. However, I would suggest strongly that you try and write the program yourself and not just copy the code directly. Otherwise, you will never learn it. Again, it's like learning to swim while you're wearing the vest. You're not gonna learn it. You'll have to jump without it. So I would suggest that you don't look at this slide yet. Leave it as a last resort and try to write the code yourself. Okay? And in that spirit, let's try and do the second tutorial without looking at the code. And essentially, here is the second program. Essentially, what we're gonna do right now is to try and write an alternately blinking LEDs. See, in the first tutorial, we wrote a program to allow one LED to blink. This time, we're gonna write another program that will allow these two LEDs to blink, but at the same time, blink alternately. Means when this one is on, this is off. When this one is on, this is off, and so on. Okay? Well, first things first, let's build the circuit. And we're gonna have to build the circuit similarly to this one. So I'm gonna basically have to go and build that one right now. Now, I want to make sure that this is not reused in any way. You know what, I actually wanna cut. I'm gonna simpan somewhere or save it somewhere. Why? Because I dislike the idea of writing from scratch. I actually like to copy paste, but it's not a good practice, but once you reach enough level of experience, you'll be comfortable doing so. Okay, so now let's start with this, and for consistency, I want to make sure that the board looks exactly like the one in the picture. So I'm gonna, if you wanna delete something, just select it and click delete button, and here we go. Oops, what happened here? Yeah. Okay, and this one I'm gonna move a little bit here. And we have to have, okay, so where's the other one? Oh, not this, okay. So, oh, okay, let's change that a little bit. And then put that here. Yeah, it's the correct setup. Let's get another one. So go back here and get another LED. This time I'm gonna make it red. It doesn't matter what color do you like. You can leave the default one if you wish. Yes, 1 kilo ohm. As long as 1 kilo ohm, the resistor is fine. Okay. And we put the same arrangement here. Okay. So notice how these are wired. First of all, these always go to the ground. So let's just settle the ground quickly. So this one go to the ground. Is it? No, the other one. Okay. I think, oh yeah, just to be safe. So I'm from here to here. And then from here to here. Okay, so now this is having grounded, and then, yeah. So now since these are connected, so these are all connected, these two are connected, so we can actually straight away come from the ground from here and put it here. Okay, let's move this whole thing so this can look cool. Okay, so this now have achieved this and this and ground. Then what's next? Next, we have to the output. So this one is to pin number 8, and this one is pin number 7. Let's do that. So I'm gonna come here and click, and we're good to go. And change the color to red. Okay. And the other one comes from here. Click, and we're good to go, and make that also red. and we're good to go. So now we have essentially built the same circuit that you see here, except that just different colors, that's all. So you have the circuit here, here, and here grounded, and then these guys are the input. Okay. Okay, the program is empty. So what we need to do right now is to essentially, we need to make them blink. Now earlier, in the earlier program, you know what, I wanna go back here. Can we do Control Z here? Oh, good. So this is the program for blink a single LED. Well, now we want to blink two of them. Okay, no problem. First things first. Let's focus on, you know what, I already copied this before, so first things first, we need to do setup. So last time we had setup, right? So now let's do another setup. So this time I want to change the setup between these two. So I know that I have two LEDs, so I'm gonna basically copy this line and paste it. So I have 7 and 8, is that right? So here is 7 and here is 8. Now, one way to deal with this much easier is to, rather than 7 and 8, 7 and 8, and down here we also, I don't want to hard code 7 and 8. I want to actually create a variable. So I'm going to call it pen or LED. No, it's going to call it red. I have two LEDs, right? One blue and one red. Is that right? So I'm going to actually call the first one red. And which one is the red? Goes to 8. Is that right? Okay. So red equals to 8. And that's it. And here I'm gonna make blue equal to 7. Okay. So we're gonna come here and put red and blue. This is also set up and I didn't do anything. I noticed that I'm running the program even without doing anything here. I just want to check the program. See here, unfortunately, we have a problem that red, this is actually a programming problem. Red was not declared in this scope, and I also didn't put semicolons, basics. So let's start here, semicolon and semicolon. So again, my inner Python. So start simulation. Again, red was not declared in this scope and blue was not declared in this scope. So, oh, okay, maybe I'm not doing it in the right place. So instead, I can just take those guys outside of the setup and put it here. I think I have to declare them integer or something like that, but I'll check. I'm not sure if that is needed in Python. Save. Now notice that I'm running simulation just to check programming error. Yeah, no type. So let's now fix this. Int, and run simulation. It's running. So notice what I just did here. Basically, there is nothing is happening. I did not achieve any blinking, but I did the start simulation to test my program. And we applied a few things from C++. We saw, first of all, the scope error, which is the variable scope error. And we also saw the variable type error. So now we can now work with these two variables, which is red and blue. So what's the problem? What's the value of these two here? Why not just put 7 and 8 here? You will see that at the end of the program. For now, let's just carry on with our work. Oh, cannot change the program while it's running. So stop simulation. Okay. So now we have done the first step, which is setup. And now we're going to do the blinking. So let us copy paste the same blinking code that we have here. Copy. And now we put it here. I'm going to start with, see, now rather than 13, I'm just going to, let's start with red, essentially red. I want to blink red right here. So yeah. So before, now if I run the program, what's going to happen? What do you think is going to happen? Once again, let's see. First, I declare two variables, red and blue, and then I set up red and blue as outputs. And then now I'm going to tell red and blue to essentially to blink. Sorry, just red, only red to blink. So only red is going to blink and nothing else. So start the program, hide. Initializing means it's still not connected yet, the power, so we're still waiting for it. Why is this taking longer now? Yep, okay, let's hide. Yep, red is blinking, but blue is not. Okay, so let's stop the simulation. Now, what's going on here now? What does the question want? The question wants alternative blinking, meaning if this one is on, this one is off, and this one is off, this is on. No problem. Well, this can easily be achieved actually right here. So all I have to do is just come here and copy this line and put it here. And essentially, all we have to do is just come here and do this, blue, and we put low here. And that's it. And then we come here now, and we get this guy, copy, and we put here, and this will be blue. And that's it. So you see what's going on here. When this one is actually high, the other one is low. And when this one is low, the other one will be high. And that's it. Run it. Initializing. And it's happening. They are alternatively blinking. If this is happening too fast, we can actually modify the sleeping time. You know what? Let's make one more integer. Red equals 7. And I want to make one more integer. So int. Sleep equal to 300. Let's make that 500 for now. And this. And then come down here and put sleep. Sleep. Once again, rather than changing the code or hard code the amount of sleep that you want, just put it here. Okay, so run it. It's happening. Now, I want it to blink faster. No problem. We just come here and change this to 100 or 200 and start the simulation. And now it's going to blink faster. Okay, so now, why put the pins here? And why not just put them here? You see, let's say I decided for some reason that I want to change the pins. I want to go from 7 to 6 here. And I want to change this guy as well from here to here. So now we have 9 and 6. Now, if I run the program, what's going to happen? Let's run it. You should know what's going to happen. And what's going to happen is nothing. So once again, why after I move the pins, things are not happening anymore? You want to see it back? Okay, let's get back here, get back to 7, and this one get back to 8. Right, start the simulation, now it's gonna work. See, it's working again, right? But when I change the pin numbers, or when I change the pins, it's not working anymore. So what's going on? Well, what's going on is that you already told Arduino that you're gonna work with pin 8 and 7. 8 for red and 7 for blue, there. Blue is for 7 and red is for 8. That's what the program is expecting. And then everything from then on will be based on 8 and 7. But since you changed now to 9 and 6, the program is not going to work because it's actually not working anymore. So how are you going to do that? Well, essentially, I can just come down here and change the numbers just one time, only here. If you hard-coded these numbers, 8, 7, all the way here, you'll have to come back and change them, all of them. You'll have to change here, 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 and more. You get what I mean? So that's why it's almost important or very powerful that you actually changed or never ever hard code the pin numbers. Always use this idea right here or this sticks. Okay, so comment pin setup. This actually has to do with the internet, so don't worry about it. Okay, so now we fixed it, 9 and 6. Initializing, and now it's working again. Now, in real life, why would you want to change the pin numbers? Very many reasons. maybe today I build the circuit and then I finished my class or my lab and then I want to go home. So I'm gonna unwire everything and then tomorrow I forgot which pins I used. So rather than going through my program and figure out the pins, I can just connect whatever I like and then it's gonna work. And I just have to go and update the code to make sure that it reflects the pin numbers that I used. Another real reason is that sometimes in some of the boards, the individual pins can get damaged, meaning the board itself is fine, but just this pin right here got damaged. Perhaps you did something wrong, you connected the wrong thing, and this pin got damaged or cannot be used for whatever reason. So then that's why in this case, you'll have to use another pin and then you'll have to change the code. All right. So this is now tutorial number two. I'm gonna do tutorial. So now you gotta go back to our program and or our slides and you can see this is the slide and this is the program that we did. Now, this is slightly different than our version. The delay, they put it slightly differently. It's the same concept. The effect is similar. So I'll leave that for you to check it out. Okay, hold push button to switch on LED. Ah, this is nice. Basically, now you have an input and you have an output. Essentially, what we want now is that we want to actually connect the circuit. And when I press the button, the LED will be switched on. When I hold the button, the LED will be switched on. And when I remove my finger from the button, it will be switched off. We will do that in the next video. So I'll see you in the next video.